Imposter syndrome is one of the most common barriers to action that I hear from other occupational therapists who are not moving forward with something that takes their work and their life to the next level. Be it a business or a product idea, applying for an important promotion or acting on a passion project. All of those I'm not good enough thoughts, what if I fail fears and worries about judgment and rejection can really be hooky. Hooky, yes, that's the technical term. When this happens, we can say you're fused to the thought and therefore not taking action on the idea, often staying in situations that are not a good fit and are draining to your energy each day. In this video, I'm going to tell you how I eliminated my imposter syndrome for good, and I go confidently and boldly into building a huge business and running through all of those daisies each day. Nope, that would be fiction, but doesn't it sound lovely? I'm actually going to tell you about my own experiences with imposter syndrome and how I continue to put myself out there in order to pursue my passion of helping as many people as I can by empowering other occupational therapists around the world. I'm Carlin Neek. I'm an OT in Calgary, Alberta, Canada, and I've had a private mental health practice for many years. I've been really excited to take all of those mental health clinical skills and apply them to supporting smart, inspired OTs who are feeling stuck. Let me tell you about my experience with imposter syndrome, and I'd love to hear in the comments if you can relate to any of this. It really helps those watching to know that they're not alone. I actually feel imposter syndrome every time I stretch. I feel it right now making this YouTube video. I'm having thoughts like, will everyone think it's too basic? Did somebody else do a better job? Are my peers judging me for using this platform? What if my friends and family see it? What will they think? Who do I think I am making a video about imposter syndrome when I actually have imposter syndrome? At the end of February in 2021, I was 3 weeks into running my Activate Vitality program in its evergreen version, having run it twice as a prototype in 2020. I'd done many webinars, Facebook Lives, Facebook posts. I was in all the groups. I had an email list and a free download. People were enjoying the content, but only one person had signed up. And I was feeling like such a fraud. I had spent more than a year preparing for this, and only one person was interested in my offer in the first month. What a disaster. What a fool I had been. Who did I think I was building this thing that nobody wanted? I'd run myself a bath with Epsom salts, and I was just setting my phone to some good feeling sorry for myself music to cry in the tub. And I saw this email and it read, I'm excited to share that Laura and I are planning to launch another virtual OT Entrepreneur Summit this year that will take place from May 3rd to May 7th, 2021. And we're reaching out in hopes that you would join us to be a speaker. You came to mind based on your take over in the OT world regarding mindset. We'd like to interview you on the topic, the number one mindset mistake made by OT entrepreneurs. Seriously, I was about to get in the tub and cry over being such a failure, so I said yes. Do you think that calmed my imposter monster? Yeah, for about a minute. And then it started in on me about what a fraud I would be talking to these budding entrepreneurs when only one person was interested in my program. So I said yes. Of course I would speak. And do you want to know why? It's because I've learned to see my imposter monster as a talisman for growth, not a truth teller. I'm going to say that again. My imposter monster is a talisman for growth and not a truth teller. He's a bit of a liar, actually. He shows up wearing a cloak of doubt each time I stretch and grow. And I've learned not to buy into his stories and make the move anyway. I also go around talking to all sorts of successful people about imposter syndrome, and I've learned it's pretty universal. I've spoken on podcasts, on webinars, and conferences and summits about imposter syndrome while having imposter syndrome. How meta is that? So let's dissect these coping strategies, shall we? First though, if you're digging this content, I sure would appreciate it if you'd click the thumbs up sign to like the video and subscribe. So a lot of strategies I used in that example surround cognitive defusion. And that's an ACT term for unhooking from the content of difficult thoughts rather than trying to talk yourself out of them. It's sort of like that meme that says you don't have to believe everything you think. ACT would say, you don't have to believe everything your mind tells you. So in these diffusion strategies, one of them is just noticing what's going on, taking that perspective of a curious observer when doubt arises. And there's a part of you engaging in the experience of doubt and a part of you observing, you having the experience, the thoughts, the feelings, the reacting. Engaging this curious observer to create just a little distance and maybe defuse just a little bit from what your imposter mind is telling you. I found it really helpful to personify the presence of imposter syndrome as my imposter monster. He's got a loud roar, but if I keep my course and do the thing anyway, he's not going to bite. I find it also helps to understand why my mind is putting all this doom and gloom in front of me. Our minds are actually built on an antiquated operating system to protect us from danger. There's more on that video over here. I've learned to create a little more distance from this imposter monster by noticing he's a talisman for growth. He only comes up when I'm stretching and doing things that expand my world. And if I can see this in the moment, I know that surely the answer is to grow rather than agree with all the things the imposter monster wants to tell me. Sometimes I'll remind myself that the imposter monster always shows up and I haven't really flopped yet. In fact, I've done some really awesome stuff and had some really amazing feedback, even when I screw up a little bit. So I keep all the thank you notes from all the years and all the kudos messages just in case I need to read them to remember I'm the real deal. Lastly, it's just good to know you're not alone in this experience. Every single person you look up to experiences imposter syndrome at some point. We just don't talk about it enough. So I'm Carlin, and I'm frequented by an imposter monster every time I stretch. So I stretch anyway. That's the key. Don't wait for it to go away, or you'll never do the thing that causes the growth. If you're an occupational therapy practitioner who needs help befriending your mind, even your imposter monster, even when it's being a bit of a jerk, I've got lots to share. I'm happy to talk to you anytime, so email me. I also have this webinar that's called When Great Ideas Meet in Action, Supporting Smart, Sensitive, Stuck OTs. There's a link in the description. I'd love to see your brilliant ideas reach the world. Oh, and don't forget to check out the OT Entrepreneur Summit. I'm really excited to be a keynote speaker on day one at the summit coming up in November of 2021.